Hey guys, it's me again. So today we're gonna do a hibiscus. Oh, and I'm doing two videos this week because like I didn't do a video last week. I was unable to do it. So this week I'm doing two videos. So let's get started with it. Oh yeah, the materials we need is a lead pencil. You can also call it a pen pencil. I'm doing a hibiscus, so I'm using a lead pencil, not eraser, and I'm gonna use the brush pens we used in the first video, that's glass thingy. Oh yeah, maybe you can see the, you know, the name of the brush pens that I used. So, Calvin brush pens. So I'm doing a normal oval just like that, but I'm doing a slanting hibiscus, that's why. Or you can also do a circle, but I prefer doing a oval. That's always a base for a hibiscus or a tulip, anything like that. And like that, and here I'm gonna start and do like that. So that's gonna be the part where those seeds are there, pollen are there. So for the pollen, I'm just gonna do like that. Can you see, guys? I just did like that for the pollen, and like that. And here we are gonna start, and I'm gonna erase the oval which is here, oval part which is here. And drawing a hibiscus is very simple, guys. Actually, you can use any color of your choice to color the hibiscus. A color which exists in a hibiscus species, actually, not any color of your choice. But, and I'm gonna leave a gap, a small gap in the middle. Like some gum a kid drew. And there you have it. That petal, maybe the camera is blur. Is it okay now? Yeah, I think it's okay. As you can see, I did like that. And I'm gonna erase the part of the oval because like I drew the one of the petal on it, so it looks straight. And this part I'm gonna erase too. I'm erasing one by one because like I don't wanna miss. The line I'm drawing in the hibiscus. Oh, and you also draw a thin thing like that, and that's the stem for a hibiscus. For the hibiscus, and right here again. can also do a front view if you want. I'm doing a side view because I like a side view for some reason. I still don't know the reason. That's why I'm telling some reason. And on this, soft inputs. That's not as tall as that, is it? So, if you drew darkly here, erase it lightly because when coloring, the lead might mix with the brush pens. And it might look ugly if you are using brush pens, that is. Or even for sketch pen, the people who are using sketch pen. I'm not using color pencils in this, or I'm not taking its name here because like it's hard to, for me, it's hard to make a flower look realistic with a color pencil. Will take a long time to shade, that's also a point. And we don't need to draw a part here because like the stem, I don't know what that is called, the stem where the seeds are hanging there. And I forgot to erase that part. And a small wrinkle will go there. So that's a thing. Yeah. So the wrinkle right there is gonna connect there. It's actually not gonna look like that. So I'll just erase it. Actually, wait a second, where's my eraser? Gotcha. And if you can hear background noises, guys, there's a party going on here. It's very annoying. That sound, actually, it's bursting my ears. You're lucky because you're seeing a video, not in real life where I'm facing this situation of it. If you live in my house, you know how it's this. And I'm just gonna erase this whole part because now I know the alignment because of this, these two petals. And this petal is not gonna be that big. None of the petals are they? Nope, they're not. Okay. If I draw like that, that would be weird. Okay, I'm just gonna connect it. I'm doing wrinkles like this. I just make it smaller. Smaller, actually. Okay, that's okay. No problem. And there you go, that's the flower. And yeah, So guys, I'm done with drawing the flower and the paper slightly tore. Excuse me for that. And I drew the leaves because I again didn't want to mess the leaves up. So this time I'm gonna show you the color combination of, wait, I'll think of a color because there are many colors in my home. The best one is orange and yellow and a peach. Also has peach, so in the middle it will be orange. I'll show you how to color it. So I took two types of peaches. I think this is not peach when you color it. Once again, is it peach? No, it is this color. I don't know the name of it. It's neon peach maybe. Who knows? I'm gonna use these three colors. So in the middle, you're gonna do like that. So there you go. That is done. And next, you'll need some yellow. So I'm done with yellow. Now next you'll need some peach. I know this is odd, but still look at it. It looks good. So I'm gonna do it very lightly or else it will leak to the next page and it won't look good at all. For me, it leaked through the next page and it's being seen. Actually, so and at the last, you'll need that neon peach. And you can just do like that. You can also use color pencils, but I'm not because it will take a long time to color with it or them. Thank you. when people are sneezing, but they're not even caring. So practically, this is how it really looks. This is the closest I can get with it. If you want to color it peach fully, you can. So for the wrinkles, I'm doing the peach. The wrinkles which practically are there. You can just color it fully peach if you want. I mean the outer layer. Now again yellow. Or you can even take orange like we did for the last hibiscus. Yellow and yellow. And now again light green and dark green, or you can just take light green like we did for the second leaf. I'm gonna shade it dark on this side when it's fully dark on the bottom. And light green on this side. There you go. This might be the longest video I've ever made. What can I do? I just am obsessed with flowers, their beauty and all. There you go. So I'll show the two things we did today. This one. And like I told you before, we do that flower, you can also do this color combination. Yeah, and there's an empty space here. Just color it. And this one. If you want, you can just do the yellow in the part which you don't. Just color it fully. And guys, please do not do this after you are finished coloring, or else it will look ugly. Just for you, I'm coloring it. I'll just assume that that's a wrinkle. So these are the two things we did today, guys. Okay, bye guys.